us blow without your money or not. Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hand on the clock. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hands on the clock. Come like a bat out of the hell, I dare you to cross like a reverend. And my energy paralyzed, I'm like I'm finger 11. Take a second, I'm finna send it like a parent a message. You the best, if it ain't me, then you need you a confession. You a mess, you ain't scary to me. Heard you was a leader, but that ain't apparent to me. Put dust on you, Vegeta, run up down the air in the scene. I feel just like Vegeta, prince, and I'm an heir to the seat. I mean, for real. Tesla driving soft, so I don't even grab the wheel. Essel on my chest, but it don't mean a man is stealing. Man, I'm walking with some money, man, I mean a couple mil. Ew, think you need a mail. You ain't even eating while I'm feasting in the field.
Today, from Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City, it's the AFC Wild Card Round on EA Sports. City Chiefs taking on the Pittsburgh Steelers.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL playoffs brings us to chilly, but of course sold out Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City. Straight ahead, it's Wild Card Weekend, and we've got a great one in store between the Pittsburgh Steelers and the Kansas City Chiefs. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks. Certainly. On third down, he'll drop to throw. That's complete to his running back, Connor. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. 5 yards, and that means they come up short as they're going to have to punt here on the opening drive.
There's an example of good situational football being played by a defense. They understood where the third down play was, the down and distance, and made sure that they didn't get anywhere near that bring up fourth down.
Yeah, they were sniffing out that marker, didn't want to let him get close to there, and now a likely three and out to start.
Yeah, I love the way they rallied to the football and got to him and made sure he didn't give up much run after catch.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10, just shy of the 30. And right away, he'll look to throw. Throw right side, complete to Williams. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. Give him 8 on the play, and it'll be second down.
At the 37-yard line, it's a gain of 8.
They go play fake. Mahomes, and going deep for Hill. Got a man, it's caught at the 6-yard line. City touchdown. Tyreek Hill, 63 yards. And the Chiefs are going to take a first quarter lead. Harrison Butker is on for the extra point. These may be an adventure this afternoon, but this one is good. Pretty clean and simple there. Just 2 plays, the long pass resulting in the touchdown on play number 2. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. That'll be taken about 1 yard deep. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
On the return, the Steelers take over first and 10.
And here now the offense heading back out there. They bring the 5 seed into the playoffs. Of course, they're one of the wild card teams. And when you're a wild card team, it makes it a little bit tougher. You have to win the extra game. But there's been a precedent set of teams doing that successfully in the past.
And it's usually teams that have aspects that really jump out at you and are really factors in the playoffs. I mean, Pittsburgh, they rode a heavy run game with Jerome Bettis when they won in 2005. And then don't forget the Giants in 2007. That season, pass rush. Remember how big that was for them during the playoffs. And for Green Bay, it was a quarterback play of Aaron Rodgers. So to me, it's a matter of, what's going to affect the game in a big way? Can that aspect of your team really make those plays? A lot of times it's pass rush and quarterback play.
And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. Call it a gain of 5 there on the run, but they'll remain a yard or two short here with 3rd down coming up.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
Well, it's a 3rd and somewhat manageable now, not so manageable.
Exactly, because you had a play call on that you felt like, hey, this could go quick, and it doesn't take much to get it done. Now, you got to start thinking about a little bit of a deeper route type of a call, especially if you want to throw it.
He'll get this to Connor underneath. And he will have a Steelers 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. A Steeler 1st down on the pickup of 11 yards.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. And it's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice 1st down. Drive keeps moving.
So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's 2nd down.
It leads to 2nd and 10.
Now a draw play. This is Connor. And he stopped immediately there.
James Connor.
Officially nothing on that one. No gain. So they're left with still 10 to go on 3rd down.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. And he's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
The threat of a 2nd straight punt to start the game is looming as they come up 3rd and 10. Ebron caught left side. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's 4th down.
Partner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands. A spin, shrugs him off. So the hold on special teams backs him up all the way inside the 15 to start. Throwing on 1st down is Mahomes. And he's going to go down. Back at his own 5-yard line, it's a sack. Cameron Hayward. It'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop him.
We said it before the game, and I think it's still apparent. If these guys are going to advance in these playoffs, they're going to have to wreak some havoc coming off the edge.
Yeah, wild card round. They told us the wild card could be that defensive pressure. They showed it there. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on 2nd down. Back near his goal line. Here's Mahomes. And Mahomes is going to go down in the end zone, and that is going to be a safety. And Charles, at some point, you can't keep worrying about big play. Can this be perfect? You just have to get the ball out of the end zone.
And in the offensive huddle, that was discussed when they called the play. Just get out of the end zone. But you know what's interesting? A lot of the times in the defensive huddle, they actually call a set and then say at the end of it, get a safety. So it's preached, it's coached, it's thought about.
Now this offense ready to head back out there. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
And he'll have a gain of 3 to the 33. Tackle made there by Frank Clark.
A 3-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 7.
Here's a 2nd and 7. Short little throw to Ebron.
The pass.
I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle it, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that, you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch. Now you put the offense in a position where every series, they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
Here's Jordan Berry now, as he'll punt it away for the 2nd time. It'll be a 39-yard punt, no return, and it's Chiefs football, 1st and 10. The Chiefs offense set to go, and last time they surrendered the safety, we know they don't want to do that again.
That is just one of those oddities in scoring that we get, and it's just so strange to see that go up on the board, and then you got to make sure that that doesn't happen to your team again. They've got to take care of the ball.
But boy, it juices up the defense.
Oh, without a doubt. That's a great way to score some points.
And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it, and it took the ball off course.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
The throw over the middle, taken in. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. First catch of this wild card game for a 1,000-yard receiver in the regular season. He's got a 1st down, too.
10 at the 41-yard line.
Rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. They fake the give. Now Mahomes. Pressure comes and the Steelers take him down.
Patrick Mahomes.
And that is the 3rd sack this offensive line has allowed this first quarter.
Yeah, that puts him on pace. Let me do the rudimentary math here. To be sacked 12 times in a game, I know he's not going to go for that. I wonder if it's going to reshape what they decide to do on offense in terms of play calling.
Well, I can tell you what, when he popped up, shaking his head, frustrated right now behind center. Got to imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on 2nd down following the sack. It's 2nd and 18. Another try after the 1st down sack. Mahomes gets this one to Hill. They get 14 back, but it leads now to a 3rd down.
I don't care who you put on him, he's going to be a handful of one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man, maybe need some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double-team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
From the gun on 3rd down, Mahomes. And it's complete to Kelce. And he will have a Chiefs 1st down. They needed 4. He doubled that. He wound up getting 8. His 1st catch of this wild card game, and it's good for a 1st down.
Well, sometimes our pregame meetings do pay off, don't they? What do the guys in the locker room call him?
Well, they said it with a chuckle. They called him Old Reliable.
Yeah, that means he doesn't move quite as fast as he used to, but he still knows all the tricks, doesn't he? Even that little gentle push-off in order to get open. He finds a way to pick up a 1st down.
Operating out of Steeler territory now. Here's 1st and 10 at the 45-yard line. Mahomes firing complete, and he gets this inside the 35-yard line. Another connection between the two. This one good for 12 and a 1st down.
1st and 10 at the 34-yard
line. Mahomes to throw once more. Caught left side, Williams. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
Nice little nifty play for him there. That's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backs out of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got everybody oh, he just snuck out there, and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down. Operating from the red zone now, Mahomes. Complete, the tight end, Kelce. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
Looking to throw again on second down. Mahomes, and he's wrapped up, taken down, back at the 25. Stephon Tuitt, credit him with a sack as he buries him for a loss of 10. Well, this has been a pretty sizable drive. They've had some success. Finally, the defensive coordinator found some success of his own.
I think he just simply said enough of that. Okay, they've moved the ball well. We need to force the issue from our end, and that's exactly what he did.
Going to need better protection here. Third and long following the sack for Mahomes and company. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. Going to throw deep for the end zone. And that is caught for the touchdown, Kansas City. Sammy Watkins there to make the grab. And the Chiefs are able to grow their lead. And man, Charles, talk about zinging something in there. Those gloves, they help with one-handed catches, the fun stuff. Any padding for a rocket like that?
One would think so, but I'll guarantee you this, after that throw, his hands will hurt later. Not right now in the moment. He's just feeling good about catching it.
Yeah, a little stinger, but a touchdown. Butker now to add the extra point. And this one gives his guys a 12-point lead. A 10-play drive that time. And it winds up with the Chiefs hitting pay dirt.
Harrison Butker.
Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Sutton now to return. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line.
At their own 25-yard line.
Pittsburgh's offense now heading back out onto the field. So far, they've had 3 drives, 3 punts. Not good.
Not good indeed, because you've got to have something to show for being out on the field. Now, sometimes, if you have a game where neither side has scored, 3 punts isn't a bad thing. But when you're trying to set the pace, get up on top in a game, you've got to show better offense and find a way to put some points on the board.
Yeah, boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain.
Brings up second and 10. At the
on second down, Connor looking for space. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4.
He's tackled at the 29-yard line. It's a gain of 4, and it's 3.
They'll look to throw here. Screen pass to Connor. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45.
Complete to James Connor. It's a gain of
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller, since the screen pass was available, whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense, and it worked very well there for a first down.
To throw now on first down. Short little throw to Ebron. No gain there on the completion. Second and 10.
That was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming. let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit. Even for those big tight ends, who you would think could absorb that contact.
Oh, he's trying for Smith-Schuster, but it's intercepted. Picked off by the Honey Badger, Tyrann Mathieu. He's had a fantastic rookie season, made a lot of lovely throws, but that wasn't one of them.
But we got to give him one, don't we? I mean, with the year he's having, a lot easier for he and his teammates to accept that throw, because for the most part, what they've seen, it's been pretty sensational.
The Chiefs offense now making their way back onto the field. And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. So now, defensively, you've almost got to get down into those starters blocks like you're a sprinter. Get lower than those guys on offense and find a way to roar through them or around them to get into the face of the passer.
Easier said than done, though.
Way easier said than done. But they've got to try something, because right now, they're just cutting them to shreds.
And he'll take this one up close to about the 45. A minimal gain as we tick down inside of a minute remaining in the opening quarter. 2 yards on the first down carry, and then followed up by 2 yards on the second down carry.
Well, that's definitely not going to be enough to get the job done. Wasn't the expression 3 yards in a cloud of dust?
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Mike Hilton. 20! And he brings this one back. It's a pick six for a Steeler touchdown. And we'll see if that pick six looms large as this game continues, because we've seen plays like that alter a lot of playoff contests over the years.
I would agree with that totally. And you often think to yourself, why do they alter it so much? Because after games, don't we hear coaches and players say, well, one play doesn't usually determine the outcome? But I don't think that's really true, do you? Because there's times when we see plays like that, and all of a sudden the momentum jumps to that team side, it deflates the other side, and they never pick it back up. And then things really go from there, don't they?
That's the thing for me. We talk about momentum changes. A play like that is the ultimate momentum change. Extra point through the snowflakes, up and good. And this is back to a 5-point game. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Here's Mecole Hardman. And he takes this near the 25, just a little pass there, call it the 26. Set to take over, Patrick Mahomes and the Chiefs. He's playing pretty well. I don't think it's necessarily him changing up something he's doing, but that O-line, they've got to protect him better.
They do. They've got to make sure that they give him more than enough time in order to find targets downfield. And sometimes what happens when these things are going on is that the field general will step up and say, hey, that's on me, guys. I didn't get rid of it fast enough. Anything to try and relax them a little bit and take some pressure off, because they do know that they are trying.
Yeah, well, we've seen the 4 sacks so far in this contest. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. We are in for a good one as we're through one on EA Sports. Second down at 5. Working from the gun, Mahomes. It's caught on the right side, Williams. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
For the Kansas City Chiefs.
They'll run out of the gun here, Williams. And very little room to maneuver. He'll get this down to about the 39. A gain of 3, second down. From the gun, it's Mahomes. Over the middle, he's got Watkins. Give him 7 on the play, and that's going to make it third down and less than a yard.
Third down.
They'll try and run for it. Here's Williams. Williams is going to have the first down and a little more. And finally taken down at the 30-yard line. Good yardage as he rumbles for 24 and a first.
We both know it's difficult, but they've made it look effortless out there. Through the air, on the ground, they've moved the ball with relative ease.
Waiting out of Steeler territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 30-yard line. Throwing now is Mahomes. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Watkins. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. A good pickup there, 26 yards. That's now 4 completions in a row. A good bounce back following the interception last drive.
Certainly not letting it affect him, that's for sure. And we all know interceptions are going to happen. So the big trick, don't let it affect you going forward. Most of the good quarterbacks, they just tell the ball boy, get that one out of the rotation, give me a fresh ball, and let's go. He's got his offense moving again.
They'll try and run. This is Williams. And he's going to take it into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Chiefs are able to extend their lead.
I know the play ends up in the end zone with one person carrying the ball, but how about that big mass of humanity that guided him to that spot?
Yeah, they got there, but I love the dive. Always a fan of the dive.
Butker on for the PAT. And this one gives his guys a 12-point lead. So that winds up a 7-play drive all told. And it results in a 4-yard touchdown run.
Harrison.
Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Sutton now to return. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line.
The Steelers take over first and 10 at their own.
James Conner and the Steelers ready to get their next drive going. He's been good. They've utilized him well, but they're losing here in the second quarter. What might they change offensively?
I think that what you try and do is expand how you get the ball to him a little bit. Get him out in open space, maybe swing the ball to him. What's that they used to call it in the West Coast offense, the long handoff?
Yeah.
Serve as your running play that way, as well as continue to feed him the football. Some of these runs now may pop bigger later in the game because of the effects of running it. Sometimes people, after a while, they don't want to tackle him anymore, or they get tired, or they get out of position, or he runs through tackles. Continue to feed him the ball. He's having that kind of game.
Yeah, might they get him the ball in some space in some different ways here? So here, the men in charge are going to be looking at whether or not the receiver had possession of the ball as he went out of bounds.
And they have to make sure that the receiver got both feet down in bounds as well.
Well, he challenged the play. It did not pay off.
And that means he lost a timeout in that challenge.
And as a coach, you hate that. Don't know if you took the advice of the player. You threw it yourself, but it didn't go your way.
At the end of the day, it all comes back to the head coach. He has the final determination on whether to actually challenge the play or not. In this case, it didn't pay off for him.
And that's got to be so heartbreaking. You throw that flag, you probably feel really confident, and then all of a sudden, boom, you lose the challenge.
Yeah, when you take a look at it, you're throwing that flag because you believe you're going to be right. And when it comes back the other way, you have to regroup.
And it's third down.
They'll try and run for it with Connor. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. Just a 1-yard pickup on the play, and it'll result in a fresh set of downs.
We ought to come up with a t-shirt and sell it that says, no indecision on third and one. And we didn't see it on that run, did we? Got his shoulders square, just got right into the line of scrimmage and picked it up.
Absolutely. Picked his lane, went with it, and converted. To throw here on first down. This is Chase Claypool on the receiving end. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. A big pickup of 38.
Big plays always wind up being a big theme as we get rolling these playoffs, and the defenses that can avoid giving them up, but they're the teams that tend to go far. You may not eliminate those big plays, but if you can limit them, then you've got a chance to get to the ultimate game.
Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's first and goal just outside the five. He'll look to throw. Got his man. It's caught for a Steelers touchdown. Deontay Johnson there to make the grab. And the Steelers are able to make this a close game again. That pass also evens the ledger for the rookie quarterback. Had the interception earlier, and now he gets the touchdown throw.
The ideal touchdown to interception ratio is what, 3-1 for the best quarterbacks? But he's a rookie. Just getting back to even is a big deal. Increases the confidence his teammates have in him as he tries to become their leader.
And this is back to a 5-point game. That time a 6-play drive. And it ends with a Pittsburgh touchdown.
Steelers 16.
Chris Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. Here's Hardman on the return. And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30.
On the return, the Chiefs take over first and 10. At their own.
Patrick Mahomes on his way out for their next drive. And he's looked pretty good. Does have the one interception, but two touchdown passes so far. Your analysis?
They'll take the offset. When you talk about throwing two touchdown passes, no one wants to see an interception thrown, but those things happen in the course of a ball game and over the course of a season. But throwing two touchdown passes, that's why the team has an advantage. That's what they're looking for more of.
They'll be hoping to make it a 3-1 ratio here in the second quarter. Give them three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7.
Brings up second and 7.
To throw, it's Mahomes. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete.
Incomplete.
The throw led him a little too far and brings up third down.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go.
And the Steeler pressure too much here. He's going to go down.
So this has been a lot like a tennis match, hasn't it? Back and forth. Both of these offenses having their way so far. So maybe the question isn't who's going to score the most points in this game. Maybe it's who's going to get some stops.
Yeah, absolutely. And that sack, finally a first step in the right direction for a stop. Now Dustin Colquitt, the all-time punting leader for the Chiefs, on to kick for Pittsburgh. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Taking it about the 36. It'll be a net of only 30 here. 40-yard punt, 10 on the return. Now we get a peek at the captain of this offense heading back out there. He's had a solid start to this game, but bottom line is they're losing, so he doesn't care about his stats. He just wants to right the ship on the scoreboard.
He wants to actually increase his stats because he feels like if he does, that means things will get better for his team, maybe get them back into the ballgame or into the lead. In these situations, I remember playing with a quarterback once where he actually ran out onto the field first ahead of everyone else just to say, guys, let's go. Try and create that energy, create that spark.
Well, so far he has one touchdown, one interception. He'll be looking for that second touchdown now. Down, he'll drop to throw. Able to hit his target, Claypool. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. The Steeler first down on the pickup of 11 yards.
Pittsburgh.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Ebron caught left side. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Same exact result as last play, a pickup of 11. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. They'll run here with Connor. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them 7 blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through, but that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
on second down now. It's Connor. Give him 2 yards that time, and it's going to leave him with a third and 11 situation.
A 2-yard gain on the play. And it's third down.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. The Kansas City defense tough to throw on there, and now it's fourth down.
Chris Boswell on for the field goal. A 37-yard attempt.
And Boswell's kick is good. And that will cut the lead down to just 2.
Chiefs 21, Steelers 19.
So that's a 7-play drive that ultimately stalls out there at the end.
And things were a little leaky in the beginning on that drive, weren't they? But how about the front 7? As they got closer to their goal line, things stiffened a little bit, forced the field goal.
Mecole Hardman on the return. The Chiefs take over first and 10 at their own.
Tyreek Hill making his way back out towards the huddle. He's doing what he's capable of, having a solid game. Not the most amazing game. He's not over 100 yards, but a good game so far.
And you just know that mentally, he feels like he's one catch away from turning it into a great game and starting on that road. And the defenders are well aware of that, too.
Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Steven Nelson.
Mahomes pass intercepted by the Steelers. They'll take over.
We don't see this often. A quarterback of his caliber, 2 first half interceptions.
It's absolutely surprising because it happens so rarely. You're searching for what reason, what's going on out there. It's not just maybe the defense is playing well. Is his horoscope off? His biorhythms? What is it?
You went horoscope on us, Davis.
Well, I was thinking maybe REM sleep was off. I'm trying to come up with something.
Anything, right? So from the 36 now, first and 10. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
It's now second and 10.
On the draw, Connor. And he'll be upended at the 33 following a gain of 3. And guess what? It brings up third down. In danger of squandering their great field position as they come up on a 3rd and 7.
Third down.
He's got a first down and much more inside the 20. And he will have a Steelers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
So from the 17 now, here's a 1st and 10. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. This will be caught just inside the 10. And he's got this inside the 10 to the 9 before he's out of bounds.
Out of bounds, down at the 9-yard line. 8 yards on the pickup, brings up 2nd and 2.
And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on 3rd down.
It's 3rd down.
On 3rd down, it's Connor. And he gets the 1st down yardage he needs before he's brought down at the 6. It's a 3-yard pickup, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
I haven't met a football team yet that runs the ball successfully that doesn't talk about having an attitude to be a running football team, right? You got to be able to put your nose in there, smell where the 1st down sticks are, and get there.
Throw here out of the gun toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. They come up here with another shot from the 6-yard line, and it's 2nd and goal now. On the draw, Connor, and he's in. Touchdown Steelers. A 6-yard touchdown run, and the Steelers have taken the lead. A strong, determined run there, Charles, to get in for 6 points.
This is why it's such a team game, isn't it? And I know it sounds really generic and it sounds almost trite, but the blocks were made up front, offensive line, collective victory at the line of scrimmage and downfield. And how about the finish to the run all the way into the end zone?
And the lead is up to 5. So that drive goes 8 plays. And it was a touchdown run by James Conner that was the exclamation mark.
Chris Boswell.
Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line.
The Chiefs take over first and 10.
Out comes Patrick Mahomes in the Chiefs offense. He's likely still kicking himself from the interception last drive that wound up leading to a go-ahead score.
And he's going to assume all that came with that one, all right? That's all on him, but he also knows he's got to erase it from his mind and get back out there. This drive, very important.
And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out by a few inches. That'll be a first down.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Here's Mahomes to throw. The tight end Kelce has it over the middle. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That goes for a Chiefs first down, 14 yards. And with that completion, he's now north of 200 yards here in the first half. Boy, a tough start for the secondary defensively.
It is, and it's got to put a dent in their confidence. And, you know, you always want to keep that up and feel like you can always bounce back after plays. But with the kind of numbers he's putting up here, it's starting to wear on them a little bit, I think. So they're looking at each other and trying to figure out what defense will work and how can they play better without getting beat deep for big passes.
Brings up second and 3.
Throwing again on second down, Mahomes. And he'll return this ball across midfield to the 47-yard line. 1:58 left to play till we hit halftime. A reminder coming up at the half, as we've done all year. We'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. Coach will have the lowdown on what's going on here in this wild card weekend as we begin on the road to Super Bowl 53 in Atlanta. And he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage.
Complete.
Call it no gain there on the first down play.
Brings up second and
back to throw now on second and 10. Ebron with it over the middle. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
It's a gain of 8, and it brings up third down.
Ebron's got it, and he's going to get this inside the 30. The Steeler first down on the pickup of 11 yards. Now a timeout called for by the offense, as he'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. He'll get that one complete to Conner. The Steelers signal for the second of their timeouts, as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. Nowhere to turn here, and he's going to go down. Back at about the 37-yard line, Chris Jones. What a play by him. That's going to go as a loss of 13.
Okay, was it a breakdown in protection? Did the running back not pick him up? What does it really matter? Sometimes it's just a great play made by the defense. Big time sack.
Now on third down, an extra DB out there for the Chiefs. Incomplete, but a penalty flag is down in the backfield. Let's get the call. So instead of giving them another third down, they'll decline it, brings up 4.
Now that's smart football right there. You don't even have to really spend a lot of time considering it. Just know that you're probably going to get the ball back. Good job declining that penalty.
Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over.
Less than 30 seconds to go in the half. Pretty good starting field position, all things considered. You'd think they definitely have time to get into field goal range.
Yes, and you get into the huddle or you come off the bench here and you've called multiple plays because you're going to say, this is how we're going to run them in order, guys. You don't have time for audibles. You don't have time to change anything. You're trying to get the ball in position to at least get three. They've got a great shot to do it right here.
Now another timeout called for by the offense as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the... And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Mike Hilton. And he's giving his guys a shot for late points as they will take over in range for a field goal or maybe more.
Take over first and 10 at the 18-yard line.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. Now here's a timeout as they're going to get it with 8 seconds remaining here in the first half. Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. Second and 3. Zone. Touchdown, Steelers. Chase Claypool in the final seconds of the first half. And the Steelers find a way to stretch their lead.
There was a lot of zip on that pass, and baseball might have called that a frozen rope.
I like it when you bring the diamond into the game. I'm going back to the gridiron. Had some heat on that bad boy. Sometimes you throw a touchdown pass, and sometimes...
You throw, what, a touchdown strike?
There you go. That's my man, in concert.
Extra point now by Boswell. And this one gives his guys a 12-point lead. They had the short field, and they made quick work of it. Just 2 plays to get into the end zone. 4 seconds, all that remain here this first half as the kick gets away. Here's Hardman on the return. So we're at halftime of this AFC wild card matchup as we'll head down to Orlando. That's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome in, everyone, to our EA Sports Halftime Report. Let's get you caught up on what's going on around the NFL. But first, let's remind everybody what's coming up tomorrow in the AFC. We've got the 3-6 game, as it'll be the Cleveland Browns from 0-16 to the playoffs. Yes, the Cleveland Browns taking on the Buffalo Bills, who are trying to win a playoff game for the first time since 1995. Meanwhile, in our game, it took a little while to get settled in, but we were in for a battle royale in this second half. And to call the action, let's go back to the guys who've been there all year. Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. Both teams try to avoid being one and done in these playoffs as we start the second half of this AFC wild card game. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29.
The Chiefs take over first and 10 at their own 29.
Set to take over, Patrick Mahomes and the Chiefs. And he's had some time to chew on that interception he threw on his last drive back in the first half.
Well, normally we say, want to get him right back out on the field and play again, right? But as you mentioned, had the halftime, had to stew about it a little bit. Maybe he'll have a chance to relax a little and kind of laugh and chuckle and let it go.
He'll hope to respond positively here to start the third quarter. He was looking for Tyreek Hill that time. That'll bring up second down.
He was covered by Steven Nelson.
Looking to throw is Mahomes. Complete, the tight end Kelsey.
Mahomes pass.
They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
And he will have a Chiefs first down as he'll be marked down a yard or two past the marker following a gain of six.
And that one was a lot of fun right there because that was the game within the game. Third and short, blitz was on. What's the key for the quarterback? Get out of your hands in a hurry. And that was a quick little completion. Got the job done for a first down.
I'll tell you, far from ideal conditions to play in, but neither offense has had much trouble. Plenty of points to go around. First and 10. Completes it to Hardman. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and 2.
It's a gain of 8. Brings up second and 2.
On second down, Williams.
49-yard line.
And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48 yard line.
Darrell Williams.
If these guys got to chop into that deficit, they got to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage to be found.
Third and 3.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. And it's complete to Kelce. And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. Travis Kelce, 52 yards. And the Chiefs are able to get this back within a touchdown. Well, that's pretty impressive, Charles. It's one thing to be an elite speed wide receiver and have all that yards after the catch into the end zone, but from your tight end?
Yeah, you don't get that very often. What you're describing is more like a Tyreek Hill, a Davante Adams, and Antonio Brown. You're not talking about a guy that lines up or can line up in line and look like an extra tackle on running plays. He took that bad boy downfield just like he was a scat back.
Before the game, he told me, I'm going to have a zinger or two today. And I was like, oh, a zinger or two? I guess that's a zinger, right?
That's a zinger.
Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee. Maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Time for the Steelers offense now to get set for their first possession of half number 2. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead. They'll come out throwing here on first down. That's complete to his running back, Connor. A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down.
He's taken out of bounds behind the line of scrimmage.
From the gun, a give to Connor. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. And he connects with Ebron. And he will have a Steelers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. That's a third down conversion of 24 yards there. Nice play.
Well, a lot of times when you get a manageable third down situation like this, you have to think about your tight end, and he comes through for him, picking up the first down.
So now first and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 48-yard line. Looking to throw, hitting Juju on the slant. And he's got this down to the 35. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time, and a first down.
A gain of 12. First down, Steelers.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
And that was good protection there. No, that was great protection there because it allowed him to lock in on his receiver, although I think he was looking for his tight end on the corner route all the way. Nice connection there for a really nice gain.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And he's going to go down. Back at the 27-yard line, he's sacked. Alex Okafor, what a play by him. That's going to go as a loss of 13. And it's never good to take a sack. You really don't want to take one down here in this part of the field, down near the red zone.
Not at all, because you're already pretty much assured of a field goal. But you take a big sack, it could push you out of range. And that's why defenses get a little more aggressive in this situation. They're almost conceding the 3 points. They want to push you back and try and take you out of that.
Now a pass that's taken in by Smith-Schuster. Down he goes at the 23, a pickup of 4. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
Third down.
Completion here to Claypool. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
Now Chris Boswell for the Steelers field goal try. This a 33-yard attempt. Boswell's kick is good.
The kick is good.
And the drive will wind up yielding 3.
36. Chiefs 28.
So the drive stalls out inside the 15-yard line, but they do get 3.
And I've talked with enough players nowadays, and when they have these types of kicks, that no one says to their guy, hey, that's just like making an extra point, piece of cake. Because the extra point's not a piece of cake anymore. But kicking a field goal from that distance, just give him confidence and let him knock it through.
KC's offense ready to take over. And they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger. A really nicely run drive.
But now the defense, what adjustments do they need to make in the passing game?
Pass rush, pass rush, pass rush. Whether it's the guys up front, or maybe you bring additional guys, but you've got to disrupt the timing of them throwing the football.
We'll see if they can disrupt it here.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. From the gun, it's Mahomes. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
And he comes back with one complete. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. That catch moves him over 100 yards now for this wild card game. And a first down as well.
Now that was a fun one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field. And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab the completion for a really good pickup.
They run the option here on first and 10. It's a gain of 7, and it'll be a second down. Pretty good first down play. Keeps them ahead of schedule, as they say.
And ostensibly, they could go right back to it because there are multiple options on this play. Hand it inside, quarterback tucks it and keeps it, quarterback throws the ball downfield. You should be able to react to the defense and have an option available on every snap.